Okay, oh man. Camera don't focus any good anymore. It's the 14th of July, it's 1:53 p.m. We got a thunderstorm coming up. It just started thundering. So at least look at the garden. Ow. And see what it looks like now before it gets really bad. I'm gonna go out back here by the garden. Videotape. Anyway. Stay here. Okay, see, that's the cloud coming up. That's west. Stop. Come on, let's go back in the house. The little chihuahua. Vice mix. She gets along with all the other two, the other three. I was gonna say the other two. CJ is over here in the ground. I think it was WBBJ said there was some severe storm supposed to come in 1 1/4 inch hail perhaps. And I want to see, look at the grass in the garden to begin with. You see all the dry stuff where I killed it off with that mix of Epsom salt, Blue Dawn, and apple cider vinegar. You see how the grass died out. Yeah, but I was trying to be careful. I didn't want to get too close to the plants. You can see when you just look out in the garden, you can see the yellow patches right away. That's why I was just spraying, like I said, trying to be careful out here. Either way, look at the watermelon all the way out here in the grass. Look, there's gonna be a watermelon too. Look, see it? I just not saw that. That's where watermelons are gonna come out. Man, it's pretty cool, first one. The black-eyed peas, all those are about 10 inches tall. The purple pole beans. See, that's a pea, I mean a different bean right there. The purple pole beans. Right there, you can see them. I'm not trying to look through the viewfinder. See them on there? That little 24-inch fencing thing. Oh, that sun. This, the sun is hot. It's just come out behind the clouds. See, that squash is not going to make it, I don't think. See the grass? See it? See the grass? I was going to dig all this up maybe tomorrow or Wednesday and put those big tomato plants I got out on the porch in here. There's squash. There's a squash. Oh, look at all them purple pole beans right there. I can't see it on here right there. See how big those are? Man, that's a lot too. I have to read up on that. Here's two more squash that are out, the yellow ones. God, that sun is hot. I'm just standing out here. Oh, I'm standing out here without my cane, so if I end up losing my balance, I'll fall. And the zucchini. This one here. It's got the zucchini going on there. You can move this camera so I can hold it down better. Right there is one. There's two more. They're yellowish green right there. Right here. And right there. They look, the other day there were three green ones down there. They looked like three little sweet pickles. Now it was just that one green one and the other two like they were. Yeah, like I said, look at the grass. I just let it go. Because all the other plants, we dig around the grass like this every couple days. Come out here and just take it by hand. Pull all this grass up. It takes about 10 to 15 minutes, just one little area. So doing that out here when it's not real hot, like tomorrow and Wednesday, will be a good time to do this. I'll tell you, it sucks to do this all the time. Anyway, that's the eggplants. See how I did all the grass. Pepper plants look okay. There's okra. Oh, I got flower on this okra plant. I just noticed that right away. Right there. Look how that okra plant, let me see if I can stand next to it. Just above, if you can let's see, comparison. It's up to my knee. I'm not that tall of a person, that either, so, but up to my knee, so you figure it's about 26 inches, maybe 28 inches. Got a flower on that one. See, I got that one, and the second one is a red okra, and then I got the first one up there, this one here, and the last one there is green okra. These are all heirloom, so, I mean, this is stuff you can't get these seeds on the market. Yeah, well, you can get it on the market, on the internet, right, but you can't just go to China Mart, to your local market nursery and say, I want some red okra heirloom seeds. They don't have that. They have the genetically modified, most of it. Yeah, look at the backs of the leaves. When you see backs of the leaves like that, you know it's going to rain generally. That is a fact. I don't know the ins and outs of that, but when you see the backs of the leaves when wind's blowing, see? That southwest storm's coming out of there. These just popped up too. Oh, look, I got peppers. I just saw this. I have some flowers on some of the plants, but look. See that one right there? Let's see if I can zoom in. See that one right there? I've got green bell peppers out here, orange bell peppers out here. I've got some jalapenos and some, I don't know if I have a cayenne out here or not. But I think I'm gonna look out here before it's not gonna rain yet. If it starts raining, I'll run like a little girl. I'll run like a sissy, run into the house. All right. God, I swear to God. I mean, the grass makes me sick. But again, everything seems to be growing okay. We're trying to delete all the grass we can when we can. And you know, as you can see, it's been like 2 days at least. But I come out here, I just grab it and whenever I can, I'll pull it out, toss it up into the yard. Gotta be careful not to hit the plant, take the plant out. I've done that in the past, last year. Be picking real fast, bunch of grass, and then pulling the plant up out of the ground. Anyway, okay. I got, I don't know if I can see. Tomatoes right there. There's some tomatoes on that one. This one's got quite a few tomatoes on it, it looks like. See right here. Here are 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 right there. There's 2, 7 on that one. Again, too, I've got probably 4 different types of tomatoes out here. This other plant I didn't count on. This one here. Got one right there. Got them in here. 1, 2, 3. I just felt, I'm feeling a couple drops. Like it's just spitting a little bit rain. I'm going back in the porch. And there's cherry tomatoes from last year. Just started growing by itself. I had about 9 of them, 10 of them out here. I pulled them all up and let this one just go ahead and go. This is the only one I'll probably have. Let it keep going. These are one of those things that you just can't get yourself rid of them. You have to constantly get rid of them. But I'll rinse this off. Actually, oh yeah, fresh cherry tomato right off the vine. Alright, well, like I said, I'm going to get in the house. It's spitting rain. Spitting rain. You see how it's all tore up from before when it come up here 3 times in 10 days and just flooded everything. So you can see how it's all dug up. But it'll be okay now. This here. See, I was going to... I was going to dig here and put the tomato, those tomato plants. Then I thought about here in between these purple pole bean plants there and here. I might do like this here, about 7 feet across, go back almost to that small squash right there. I don't think that squash is going to make it. I might end up having to take it up. I can't even see it on this viewfinder. Anyway, I've got about 6 tomato plants over here, 6 or 8 tomato plants. And I put those down over here. If not, it'll be in between these right here. Yeah, because this is a good area here. I could put like a double row all the way back if I had to. I mean, it's late to till it all up, but you know, just to put those out here, I will. Anyway, getting ready to come down some rain. I can see it in the distance under the trees over there. I can feel it now. It's spitting a little bit more. Yeah, it's dripping on me. So,